Good evening, friends. I think we are very tired after writing the IAS preliminary examination for the year 2018 today. So let's see the answers for the questions which you have written in the morning. I hope you have seen already the part 1 of the video which you uploaded for the answer key, which is associated with science and technology and environment. This is the part 2 which we are going to discuss, and I will be discussing the questions associated with history and geography, and the set we have taken for our understanding and discussion is set A. So let us go directly into the answers. I will not be discussing each and every question very elaborately. The elaborate answers will be uploaded today evening, late evening, or by tomorrow morning we will be uploading the elaborate answers. So just we will directly go into the answers, and just I will use some logic in how to solve these answers we will use, which I hope you will accept. So question number 11, he wrote the biographies of Mazzini, Garibaldi, Shivaji and Sri Krishna, etc. All this description fits very best to Lala Lajpat Rai. So the answer for question number 11 is C, Lala Lajpat Rai. Next is question number 13. Which of the following have shrunk immensely, dried up in the recent past? This question, the probable answers for this is RLC. So one should come in the answer. So C and B is not the answer because one is not present. Now the question is whether Lake Baikal is present or not. And as the description gives, Lake Baikal is also the lake which has shrunk recently because of human activity. And now the question about the Lake Baikal is that the scientists are still confused the reasons for the shrinking of the Lake Baikal. Is it because of the human activity or is it because of some other natural calamity? The discussion is going on. But still, most of the people can directly link the shrinking of the lake to human activity. So in this regard, I am going to take answer as D. So question number 13, answer is the D. Next, question number 18. Very recently, in which of the following countries have lakhs of people either died? The key point here is famine, malnutrition due to starvation caused by ethnic conflict. So since all the countries are associated with some conflict, malnutrition issues, etc. Since the term ethnic is coming, so I am taking the answer Yemen and South Sudan is answer. Question number 18, answer is D. Next, question number 19. Regarding Wood's dispatch, which of the following statements are true? This dispatch is associated with 1854 during the time of Dalhousie. So which is the answer is going to be true? So I am just going to take one statement which you will all accept. The statement 3, English as a medium of instruction at lower level of education was recommended. If you see in the Wood's dispatch, the English as a medium of education is recommended, not all level. So in the lower level, it is vernacular. In the middle level, it is vernacular plus English language. In the higher level, only English has been introduced. So statement 3 is wrong. So all the statements where 3 is coming, I am going to eliminate. So answer is going to be A. Next, for question number 22. And it is a simple question, factual question. So first and second is correct. The third Sikkim it is given, it is not correct, third Sikkim. So the question number 22, answer is B. Question number 24, the term two state solution, it is associated with Israel and the other state is Palestine. So the question 24, answer is B, is Israel. Next, question number 27, consider the following statement. In India, the state governments, let's take one statement which is correct or wrong, we'll take this. Rajasthan has got iron ore mine. Yeah, in Rajasthan we have iron ore mine. So 3 should be in the answer. So A is not the answer, B is not the answer. Second statement, Andhra Pradesh and Jharkhand do not have gold mines. You should know that in Singbhum district of Jharkhand we have gold mines, and in Andhra Pradesh also we have gold mines. So the second statement is wrong. So I am telling B and A is not the answer. So in India, the state governments do not have the power to auction non-coal mines. That's also correct. So the answer is going to be question number 27. The answer is going to be C. Next, question number 29. Among the following cities, which one lies on the longitudinal closest to the Delhi? So the answer is Bengaluru. So it is just one longitude slightly this and that side. So question number 29, answer is A. You can refer in the map. The answer is A only. All others are slightly away from the longitude of Delhi. So next, question number 37, consider the following pairs. So Alipur, Kirkuk, Mosul and the countries have been given. We all know Kirkuk is in Iraq and Mosul is also in Iraq. So 2 and 3 are wrong. So 2 and 3, whichever the place is located, is not the answer. So I am eliminating all. The answer is B. So question number 37, answer is B. Next, question number 38. In the Federation established with the Government of India Act of 1935, residuary powers were given to, we all know legislature will not have the residual powers. So A and C I am removing. So the rest of the options is B and D. So among them, the most apt option and the correct answer is Governor General. So 38, answer is B. Next, 42. The well-known painting Bahani Thani belongs to, the different schools have been given. This painting had been painted, it is a miniature painting which has been painted roughly in 1750s. It has been often compared with the Mona Lisa paintings of the West. So here the appropriate school happens to be Krishnagar School. So 42, answer is D. 44, with reference to the cultural history of India, consider the following statements. Just we'll see one statement which is correct or wrong. We'll see question number two means statement two. Tyagaraja created several new ragas. That should be correct statement. So two should come in the answer. That answer where two is not coming, I am going to eliminate. So I have eliminated option A. Now Annamacharya and Tyagaraja are contemporaries is given. So Annamacharya the period is approximately 1400s to 1500s and Tyagaraja the period happens to be 1750s etc. So there is they are not contemporaries. So the third statement is wrong. Three should not come. So if I see in that option, answer is B. So 44, answer is B. Next is 51. After the Santal uprising subdued, what was the measure taken by for the 51 question? So the territory called Santal Pargana was created. That is correct. One has to be there. It became illegal for Santals to transfer land. Yeah, that's also correct according to the Santal Act. So question number 51, answer is C. Next, question number 52. Economically, one of the results of the British rule in India in 19th century was, first we all know answer A and B is not the answer, so I am eliminating both answer A and B because increase in exports of the Indian handicraft, growth in number of Indian owned factories, they are not correct and the answer should be either C or D. Rapid increase in urban population is not most appropriate. So among the given answers, 52, C is the answer. Commercialization of Indian agriculture, the crops became commercialized, so that is the reason. So 52, answer is C. Now next question is question number 54. Consider the following fairs. Suji embroidery is not in Maharashtra, it is in Bihar. So Upad Jamdani saris, this also is not in Karnataka, it is in Andhra. So the answer, correct answer is Puthukuli salts is in Tamil Nadu, it is in the Nilgiris. So the answer for this is 1 only, 54, answer is A, 1 only. Next, 57, the earth's magnetic field has reversed that's correct, first statement is correct. And here, when the earth was created more than 4,000 million years ago, there was 54% oxygen. No, that's wrong. Because there was no oxygen content, the oxygen was very, very negligible, very less, it is negligible. So second statement is wrong. So second statement is wrong, all this is gone. So when living organism originated, then only the atmospheric composition got changed. So answer 57, answer is C. Next, 68, the staple commodity of export by the East Indian Company from Bengal, we are given in the 18th century, which is approximately 1750s and later. So let's eliminate some of the options here. Option A, raw cotton, oil seeds and opium is there. So I am eliminating oil seeds in this because oil seeds from Bengal, it's not grown and it's not exported. Option B, sugar, salt, zinc and lead. Salt is not exported, we must know. Salt at one point of time have been imported from Britain, so it is not exported. Copper, silver, gold, spice, tea, etc. So I am just having copper, gold and other things is not exported. So the right option among the given option may be 68, answer is D. So 68, answer D is the most apt answer according to all the options which is given. Next, 69, which of the following is a very significant aspect of Champaran Satyagraha? So here I can very easily eliminate the option A and B because participation of lawyers, students, it is given all India, that's itself wrong because Champaran movement is just restricted to the regions of Champaran. So active involvement of Dalit, so all that is not correct. So the most appropriate answer for 69 is answer C, joining of peasant interest to Indian national movement is correct. Drastic decrease in cultivation of plantation crops and commercial crops, it may be correct for indigo because indigo had been totally, the cultivation of indigo had been totally means gone away, but other commercial crops seems to have continued. So 69, answer C is the correct answer. Next, 70, who among the following were the founders of Hindu Majdoor Sabha? So the answer is D, it is a factual question, I need not have to discuss much. So 70, answer is D. Next, 71, with reference to the religious practices in India, the term Santpsi is given, belongs to which? Actually it is Jainism. Swatambra sect of Jainism is that Jainism where that sect is belonging. So 71, answer is B, Jainism. Next, 72, with reference to the cultural history of India, consider the following statement, it is given. White marble was used in making Buland Darwaja. So this white marble, Buland Darwaja, they don't go hand in hand because Buland Darwaja was made by red sandstone. So the first statement itself is wrong. So when the first statement is wrong, both is gone, A is also gone. So red sandstone marble were used in the making of Bara, Imam Bran and Rumi Darwaja, that is correct. So second statement is correct, 72, answer is B. Next, 73. Which of the following foreign travelers elaborately discuss about diamonds, diamond mines? We all know in the medieval India, one traveler had come to India, he visited Golconda and discussed about diamond mines, etc. And this traveler happens to be Jean Baptiste Tavernier because he himself was a merchant, diamond merchant. He had come from France. So he came to visit this Golconda and procure diamond, etc. So 73, answer is B. Next, 74. With reference to the Indian history, who among the following is the future Buddha? Future Buddha is Maitreya. All other options are associated with Buddhism maybe, but it is not future Buddha. Maitreya is the correct answer. So 74, answer is C. Next, 75. Which among the following statement does not apply to the system of subsidiary alliances introduced by Lord Wellesley? Now you see, to maintain a large standing army, that is correct, to keep India safe from Napoleonic danger, many people think that this is not the correct thing, but that's also correct, you must know, because during the time of Wellesley only Napoleon had had its emergence in France, and he was trying to expand to Europe and other places. So I think the second statement is also correct. To secure a fixed income to the company, yeah, by subsidiary license treaty a fixed income came to the company. But option D, if you see, to establish British paramountcy over the Indian states. This is not during the time of Lord Wellesley. It is after Lord Wellesley, which happens to be during the time of Marcus Hastings. So 75 answer is D. Next, 76. Which of the following led to the introduction of English education in India? All the three are correct, because by the Charter Act of 1813, only 1 lakh rupee was been allotted. General Committee on Public Instruction was appointed, and they decided how to spend the money. And that's all subsequent. One after another, all the things are coming. So Oriental English controversy led to only Macaulay taking his decision of giving English as a medium of education in India. So all are correct. So answer is D. 76 answer is D. 77. Which one of the following is an artificial lake? It's a factual question. Kodaikanal lake, it's an artificial lake. It's a man-made lake in Kodaikanal, Tamil Nadu. So 77 answer is A. Next, 79. In 1920, which of the following changed its name to Swarajya Sabha? It's All India Home Rule League. In 1920, it changed. So 79 answer is A. These are the factual questions. We will not have to discuss more about this. It's not a discussion-based question, just a factual question. Next, 80. Which among the following events happened earliest? So Deen Bandhu Mitra wrote the Neel Darpan in 1860s, Neel Darpan. Swami Dayananda established Arya Samaj in 1875. Bakim Chandra Chattopadhyay wrote Anand Math. This Anand Math story is as early as 1770s. He speaks about the story of 1770s, which is about the revolt associated in Bengal. This book was been written in only 1880s. So, Satyendranath Tagore became an ICS officer in 1863, we all know. So, among them, the earliest happens to be Deen Bandhu Mitra wrote Neel Darpan, that is in 1860, that is correct. So, 80 answer is B. Next, 81. Which of the following is or possible consequence of heavy sand mining in the riverbeds? We all know, 3, lowering of water table, this everybody will accept. So, A is not the answer, easily we can eliminate here. Now, pollution of the groundwater. Of course, the groundwater gets polluted because when the sand is being quarried, very easily the dump which you put on the river, it easily percolates into the groundwater. So the groundwater also gets polluted. So two also should be present. Decreased salinity in the river. There is no connection between this decreasing in salinity. Maybe there is a possibility that the salinity will increase, but there is no possibility that the salinity will decrease. So 81 answer is B. So next, 82 question. With reference to agricultural soils, consider the following statement. A high content of organic matter in soil drastically reduces its water holding capacity. Organic matter will suck the moisture and keep the water, so it increases actually. So first statement is not correct, it is a wrong statement. So one should not come, so all the answer is gone. So only answer is B, because you see, irrigation over a long period of time can contribute to salinization of some of the agricultural land, that is correct. Alkalization over a long period of time, if you irrigate, of course the capillary reaction, all these things you know. So 82 answer is B. Next, 85. Consider the following statement. Barren Islands volcano is an active volcano located in Indian territory. Of course, that is correct. It's a very important active volcano. It's only one of the active volcanoes in the whole of Asian region. So first statement is there. Barren lies about 140 km east of Great Nicobar. No, it is not east of Great Nicobar. It is north actually. Maybe in the North Andaman, and the east of North Andaman is located. So the second statement is wrong. The last time the Barren volcano erupted is 1991. It's wrong. We have eruptions recorded as late as 2016. So both the statements are wrong. 85 answer is A. Next, 87. Consider the following statement. Most of the world's coral reefs are in the tropical waters. That is correct. The first statement is correct. More than one third of the world's coral reefs are located in the territories of Australia, Indonesia, Philippines. Of course, they are coral triangle. All they are present there. So the second statement is also correct. But the third statement, coral reefs host far more number of animal playa than those hosted by the tropical rainforest. If you compare percentage wise, the state statement is a statement which there is a bit doubt, because if you see, if you compare percentage wise, 50% of tropical rainforest consists of 50% of diversity of species, whereas coral reefs consist of around 25% of the species diversity in the water. But I am thinking that the 25% of ocean coral formation is more than 50% of land. So I think the third statement I am giving as third statement as correct. I have accepted because of the relative factor. So 87 answer is D. Next, 89. With reference to the education institution during the colonial India, consider the following pairs. So you see, first statement is correct. Sanskrit College, Banaras, William Jones, Calcutta Madrasa, Varanasi is also correct. Fort William College, Arthur Wellesley should be correct. It is not Arthur Wellesley actually. The answer is Richard Wellesley. Richard Wellesley and Arthur Wellesley are brothers. They are not connected with Fort Williams. Richard Wellesley, who happens to be a Governor General in India, he is the one who started Fort William College. So Arthur Wellesley is different. So he is not present in the answer. So 89, answer is A. So question number 90, consider the following statement. It is a map based question. We have given some places and the country has been given. Crimea, we all know, is not located in Hungary. It is located in Ukraine. So the second statement is wrong. And the fourth statement, if you see, Urmia, it is not located in Nigeria. It is located in Ethiopia. So the answer is 1 and 3 only. So that is the answer is C. So next question is 91. First democratically elected Communist Party government formed in the state is in 56. So 1956. So India's largest bank, Imperial Bank of India, was established, renamed of, means it is established in the State Bank of India. It is in the year 1955. And Air India was nationalized and became the national carrier is in the year 53. And Goa became, it's 1961. So it should be last. Goa 4 should be in the last. So the only two possible answers are B and D. So the answer, correct answer is 91, answer is B. So 91 question, answer is B. Next, 94, it's a simple question. Which of the following state Phukli Wildlife Sanctuary is located at? The answer is Arunachal Pradesh. It's a simple question, straightforward question. Question number 94, answer is A. So we have completed the part of history and geography. Though the discussion was a bit fast, the purpose of this discussion happens to be to give you the answers right now, and the whole detailed explanation will be uploaded tonight or tomorrow morning. Please stay tuned and watch the part 3 of the discussion. Thank you.